is the West in the middle of a pre-war era.
NATO's biggest battles and fights are still in the future.
Russia already considers itself facing a direct confrontation.
Ukraine will become a member of NATO.
As the headlines from Ukraine darken, Western nations are openly preparing for war. On the technological front, the battle has already begun. While Western leaders were cutting NATO's 75th birthday cake in Brussels, a new super partnership of startups and disruptors was teaming up to control the future of tech. NATO's Defense Innovation Accelerator, known as Diana, is on a mission to solve critical defense and security challenges by investing in cutting-edge technologies. With a staggering $1 billion fund, Diana is empowering 44 hand-picked startups with access to top-tier defense expertise, investors, and resources to supercharge their growth. One of the key areas it is looking for solutions in is sensing and surveillance for subsea offshore zones. The sabotage of Nord Stream gas pipeline, which both Russia and Ukraine blamed on each other, could be just the start.
Now, Russia's been accused of planning a campaign of sabotage against energy infrastructure in the North Sea.
The Dutch government claimed Russia could be preparing to attack offshore wind farms after it was forced to escort a Russian vessel out of Dutch waters. There have also been calls for NATO to focus its attention on wind infrastructure in the Baltic Sea. Enter three startups now working for the Western Alliance. Belgian company DotOcean has developed what it says is the first cloud-based surveillance radar network, enabling perimeter surveillance for wind farms and other infrastructure.
We make software to enable autonomous vessels.
Another company, CEDAR, claims it has developed the first subsea radar system capable of detecting, geolocating and mapping all forms of metallic materials above and below the sea floor.
CEDAR is well suited to a range of applications, from search and recovery missions, battery metals exploration, and unexploded ordnance detection.
A third startup, French developer L-Wave, claims to be the world's first and only company to offer products and systems based on innovative electric sensing technology, inspired by electrical sensory perception of some tropical fish, that it says can help monitor offshore infrastructure, including wind farms. These technologies combined could give Western countries the edge they need to counter and prevent any major attack beneath the waves. As the North Atlantic Treaty Organization turns 75, geopolitics are shifting rapidly, with the West facing growing challenges from both Russia and China.
The United States has more friends and more allies than any other major power.
Maybe so, but winning on the technological front is far from certain. Through Diana, NATO is not just investing in innovation, it's hoping to shape the future of security for generations to come. And it's just getting started. What do you think? Let us know and keep watching Technality for all things future, tech, and humanity.